Hello everybody, today we are going to take up Discovering Tut, The Saga Continues by A.R. Williams. This lesson is a fascinating story about King Tut, his life and how he eventually died and the mystery behind his death. Now let me tell you first, who was Tut? Tut was a Egyptian pharaoh, the last heir of a powerful family that had ruled Egypt and its empires for centuries. The most intriguing about King Tut was that he died when he was just a teenager. His body was mummified as every Egypt pharaoh was like done. His tomb was discovered in 1922, and as soon as he was discovered, his body was discovered, the speculation started about what happened to him. Why did he die so young? So murder being the extreme possibility which wasn't ruled out, rather it was weighing on everybody's mind that how did he die so young. Our lesson, Discovering Tut, The Saga Continues, starts with Tut's body being taken up from his resting place, that is the Valley of Kings, where his body was buried. It was quite a strange and eerie atmosphere. The angry wind stirred up ghostly dust devils. That means it was quite stormy. The dust storm was blowing when Tut's body was taken out from his grave. It was dark and dreary because of the dark bellied clouds hurried across the desert sky. On 5th January 2005, Tut's mummy was taken out for CT scan to probe about the mystery of his death, which happened nearly 3,300 years ago. On that afternoon when the body was taken out, the tourists visited that tomb, which was 26 feet underground, to pay their respects. Some tourists gazed at the murals. Murals means the paintings on the walls in the tomb, in the burial room. Some were fascinated about the gilded face, the gold mask which was covering the mummy's face. Some were reading the guidebooks, and some perhaps were thinking on the untimely death of this King Tut. Some tourists were quite scared about the Pharaoh's curse, the curse that whoever would disturb the body, death or misfortune may fall upon him. Tut's mummy was basically discovered by Howard Carter, a British archaeologist, in 1922. In the burial chamber, along with his body, he found many beautiful antiquities, which remain the richest royal collection ever found with any of the mummies. Howard Carter was not very careful while dealing with the antiquities because he ransacked, he roughly dealt with each and everything there, though it was like complete. And the Egyptians believed in resurrection, that is rebirth, and that is why they kept all these things related to daily needs inside the tomb of a dead. So even Tut was buried with everyday things like he would be wanting afterlife, like board games, a bronze razor, linen undergarments and cases of food and wine. So Howard Carter was he recorded each and every funerary treasure. Funerary means whatever was related to during the burial the things which were
kept beside
the Tut's body. The body of Tut was kept in three nested coffins. When he opened the first coffin, he found various things like olive leaves, celery, lotus petals and cornflowers, and this gave an evidence to him that the burial of Tut was somewhere in March or April. So when he removed all the coffins, when he reached the body, he faced a big obstacle, that the body was stuck to the base. The ritual raisins means the chemicals or the sticking material which was used while burying Tut, had hardened the body with its base. So the major obstacle or the hurdle which Carter faced was to move the body from its base. But he also applied force, but he couldn't move the body. He also tried other ways, like keeping the body outside in the sun at 149 degrees Fahrenheit, that means 65 degrees Celsius. In Egypt, it's quite hot. But the mummy could not be, released from the base. So he used a chisel to cut away or release the body from the base. Carter defended his stand by saying that if he wouldn't have cut the mummy free, the thieves would have certainly, escaped the guards and ripped off all the gold and escaped from there. We get to know that these kings were quite wealthy, and they were buried with riches, like they were lavished with glittering gold, precious collars, inlaid necklaces and amulets. Amulets is like tabis, protecting from the evil, so as to take away all the adornments, the jewelry from the body. Howard Carter, what he did was cut every joint and even severed, cut the head to take away the jewelry from. Because the archaeologist then, during the time of Howard Carter, was basically interested in the jewelry and the artifacts which were there with the body. But as the years rolled by, the archaeology now is basically focusing less on treasure and more on the fascinating facts of life and the intriguing mysteries of death. Intriguing means basically raising questions, mysterious. So it was Howard Carter in 1922, he discovered the body and he took out the body, and then he laid back the body again and put the padding and concealed the damage. Then again the body was taken out in 1968, more than 40 years after Carter's discovery. And the anatomy professor who x-rayed the body found that a shocking fact, that from Tut's body a breastbone was missing, and even his front ribs were missing. So when the lesson starts, the body has been taken out the third time in to CT scan and find out the two biggest questions which were lingering, which were still, going on, that how did he die and what was his age when he died. His dynasty ended with his death, because he was the last powerful heir of that dynasty. Then we get an insight into his family, about his Tut's father or grandfather, which the historians are not clear about. That Amenhotep III was like a powerful pharaoh. Pharaoh means king, who ruled decades at the height of 18th century. When his son Amenhotep IV came into power,
He brought about many changes. Amenhotep IV, that means. He promoted the worship of Aten, the sun disk. He changed his name to Akhenaten, that is servant of Aten. And he also moved his capital from old city of Thebes to the city of Akhenaten, now known as Amarna. He was a weirdo as he smashed all. He didn't believe in Amun, a major god of Egyptian, and rather he smashed all his images and closed the temples of Amun. So towards his end, he went a little wacky. Wacky means crazy. Tut arrived on the scene when a mysterious ruler named Semenkhkare, his predecessor, died. Tut was quite young, an unripe age of 9 when he became the king. And after becoming the king, he changed his name from Tutankhaten to Tutankhamun and revived and restored the old ways. He started the worship of Amun the god and opened the temples. Then the author puts it that King Tut is one of the first mummies to be scanned in death as in life, moving regally ahead of his countrymen. This means that King Tut's body was the first to be CT scanned and had the privilege after his death. So even when he was alive, he was regally ahead of all the kings. He was an eminent and a famous king. So when we get to know when the body was taken out this time in 2005, Tut's body was CT scanned from head to toe, and they took 1700 digital images, which when put together came up with how it looked when he was alive, with eerie detail. Eerie means weird, a strange image. So a team of specialists of in radiology, forensic and anatomy were engaged to probe into the secrets of his. Tut's body was scanned head to toe, resulting in 1700 digital x-ray images in cross section, and his head was scanned in 0.62 mm slices. This was done in less than 3 hours, and the body was again laid to rest in the tomb. Zahi Hawass, the Secretary General of Egypt's Council of Antiquities, who was to see the whole process of CT scanning and seeing that no damage is done to the body or other things, expressed satisfaction and relief after the successful completion of the scanning process. Tut was laid to rest in peace in his tomb, guarded by Osiris, the god of the afterlife. Ultimately, the team of scientists found out that Tut was not murdered, but he died of infection.